Hey, West Ottawa. So a quick video on how to set up your online testing rosters. So you're going to click View Assessments. You are going to select your assessment. And then under Administration, you're going to click Online Testing. So I have a ton of rosters already set up here. But to set up a new roster, you're going to come up here and you're going to click Test in Portal. So you have a lot of different security features that can prevent students from accessing tests when you don't want them. The first one is your testing window. Ultimate test security is to set up the testing window. So if I'm going to give this test today during first hour, I'm going to set this up for 7:45 a.m. to 8:50 a.m. Have to make sure that you change the date as well to the same date, and that the test will only be open or available to students during that time. That's not the only security feature, but that's one. One of the first things that I'm going to recommend to you is that you create separate testing rosters for each class. Don't put all of your students on the same testing roster. By doing this, you are that way you can keep the test only open during specific hours for the timing. It also, when you're in assessment, the assessment panel and able to watch students as they take it, that will also be helpful there, so you're not overwhelmed with the number of students. And then you're going to come down here to administration settings. So you'll go through. I would not mess with any of these first few. So online entry, I would always add a password. So in this case, I can just use test one. I typically will put test and then the number of the hour, or a word and then the number of the hour. That way I can easily identify which one is which. Do not change any, or this, make sure it's on any browser device. That will mess up and students won't be able to access the test. You can randomize the choice order so that students, you know, again, another piece of test security. The only thing to be conscious of is if you do this and then a team teacher is reading the test, so you print out a PDF version of the test for them to read, then the answers that they are reading won't match the letters that the kids are seeing necessarily. So that I do not turn on randomized choice order for that reason. It makes it a nightmare. Tool settings. You have all these different tools that you can turn on. This is a conversation to be had at the PLC level on what you want and don't want. TTS is text to question, text to speech, excuse me. So you can turn on the ability for the students to have the questions or the passages read to them. Then you come down to assessment review. So you can basically turn on for this window of time whether or not kids will see the results of the test after they've taken it, at least the portion that's automatically graded, and then whether or not you want them to have a key. So you set all that up, you'll click save, and you will see here that test roster. And it is, the bar here is green because as you see down at the bottom, if it's yellow, that means it's set up, but the window is not open yet. If it's green, it means the window is currently open. If it's red, it means that window is closed. So that's how you do it. Pretty straightforward. And again, I would do one of these for every section that you have.